because it is the most expensive structure of its kind on Earth. 10 times the cost of the Houston Astrodome. And even though they're working day and night now, it might not be finished on time. The creator of this grand design is the French architect Roger Taillibert. He's a mystery to most Canadians, but well known in Europe for his bold and lavish designs of sports and leisure facilities.
Monsieur Taillibert, aged 48, is a Parisian. His achievements as an architect are impressive. Among them, a satellite town near Saint-Germain-en-Laye outside Paris, a huge sports center in the valley of the Chamonix in the French Alps, and a Paris soccer stadium, Le Parc des Princes, that seats 50,000 and cost only $17 million to build. Monsieur Taillibert is not content to be called an architect or an engineer. He prefers to describe himself as a builder who can go into raptures about his Montreal work.
Ce bâtiment exprime là.
This building contains the first large structure that actually leans into space. But at the same time, it is a structure that is perfectly balanced. Look, it's stable, even though it's a model. It's balanced by its center of gravity. This balance is part of my concept.
The sports complex in the Chamonix is a training ground for highly skilled athletes, and it has university facilities to make sure they get an education as well. Taillibert's designs did not please everybody. Some critics accused him of ruining the beauty of the Chamonix Valley. This is his response to criticism.
There are always critics. Only those who do nothing have no critics.
Monsieur Taillibert has little time for critics and less time for anyone inquiring about the fees he collects for his work. He resents such questions. He also resents suggestions that public buildings, even stadiums, should pay for themselves.
Why should we recover money spent on public facilities? They are public facilities. It's like a highway. It's a need for the community. A hospital doesn't have to recover its money, does it?
In getting Monsieur Taillibert, Montreal netted one of the world's great architects. At the same time, it acquired an enormous financial burden. The structures designed by him for the Olympics have become so incredibly expensive that at first glance the costs look like a crazy computer error.
The original estimate for the cost of the stadium was $120 million. The current estimate, $564 million. Mr. Taillibert also designed the velodrome, which is built for cycling events. The original estimate on that was $12 million. The current estimate, $59 million. Something is terribly out of kilter. On the one hand, one can talk with wonderful, grandiose, philosophic abstraction about architecture expressing the soaring spirit of humankind. On the other hand, you wake up with a thump and wonder who's going to pay the bills. There was nobody in Montreal's city council chamber to ask that kind of embarrassing, grumpy question when the games were pushed through a couple of years ago. But now there's a full-fledged opposition, the Montreal Citizens Movement. Councillor Nick Auf der Maur is the official critic of the Olympic Games. Well, who actually hired Taillibert?
Well, the mayor did. It's kind of odd that we could say he's hired. He still hasn't signed a contract, of course, but the mayor hired him 4.5 years ago or 5 years ago and had him work secretly on the plans, and he produced these plans for this modest stadium, for the modest Olympics we're going to have. The mayor has this, he has this feeling of he likes grandeur and prestige, and the mayor wants somebody who can build pyramids. He doesn't want people who can build anything mundane or ordinary, and so he has this pyramid builder, Roger Taillibert. But it's kind of a strange relationship. It's not a business relationship. It's certainly not. It's not a relationship that you would normally expect to find in public administration, where somebody is kind of selected mysteriously like this, and where he has got a verbal arrangement, and he puts in a bill every now and then, and they give him a check for $500,000 or $900,000.
How much money is he costing?
Well, we got a copy of his contract of the projet d'entente, which the mayor claims is not really it, but he's never produced another written agreement or anything else. And we calculated by analyzing this contract that basically he collects 5% of the total construction costs, and he's responsible for slightly over $600 million of the entire expenditure, so that's $30 million, plus his expenses, unlimited expenses, That includes all the draftsmen and all the other people he has.
Monsieur Taillibert blames the unions for the tremendous increase in Olympics costs.
Salaries in North America are $1,000 a week, and that's a fantastic amount. I should point out also that over there we are being forced to work night and day to finish before the deadline. And why is that? Because of manpower, slowdowns, union intervention, and many other things. By slowdowns, I mean strikes. There are a lot over there. That's the way of things in rich countries.
Time lost by labor disputes has caused some delay, and last winter, Quebec government officials had to step in and settle a six-week strike. But the unions can't be blamed for everything.
One of the major problems in the construction of this adventure here is it wasn't very well organized. And what happened originally, the Public Works Department of the City of Montreal was supposedly in charge, and they hired a project coordinator, Lalonde Valois Lamar, and then there was Taillibert, the master builder, and nobody really knew who was in charge, and people were giving counter orders, and nobody could make a decision. Everybody was afraid to make a decision. So you had you had the artist or the master builder, you had the project coordinators, and the Olympic Spark Division of the Public Works Department. All of them working at cross purposes, and it was very, very badly organized. You had all these cranes, which we were paying almost $100,000 a day in just renting the cranes, weren't being used. I was speaking to some workers, for example, a welder a few weeks ago, and he was working 7 days a week, 10 hours a day, and his gross pay was $1,200 a week. And I said, how many hours did you work out of that, really, in the an average a week? And he said about 2 hours. He put in 2 hours' work. The rest of the time was standing around waiting to be called to do something.